Dear friends and viewers, today we are going to discuss one more very important topic, that is outbreeding devices. So, as we all know that majority of the angiospermic plants are bisexual, hence we can say that the self-pollination is more often. So when self-pollination occurs, so there will be inbreeding depression. So what do we mean by inbreeding depression? Inbreeding depression is an important aspect where the qualities of the characters will continuously decline. So to avoid or to discourage the self-pollination and to carry out cross-pollination, we have the devices known as the outbreeding devices. In fact, which is very necessary for carrying out cross-pollination, and cross-pollination, as we all know, results in variations, that is, we can say in other term as genetic variability, recombination. It contributes for evolution and it is highly significant for the production of hybrid plants and so many other important aspects we have of cross-pollination. So outbreeding devices are highly essential in angiospermic plants. So, many adaptations or contrivances are shown by the angiospermic plants to carry out the cross-pollination and to avoid self-pollination. So, those adaptations we can find with respect to outbreeding devices. So, firstly, here we have is dicliny or unisexuality. So, when I say this, you can easily understand that the flower may have either the andrecium, that is the male reproductive part, or the gynoecium, that is the female reproductive part, but not both. So in that case, what happens, as we all know, so the cross-pollination is the only possibility. So example, as in the case of palms, casuarina, morus, we can find the dicliny or unisexuality. So secondly, we have dichogamy. So dichogamy is the one which in fact is very important for us to understand. So here, the maturation of the stigma and the other, the male reproductive parts, that is the stamens, so or the anthers, will take at different intervals of time. So this we need to take into consideration. Again, under dichogamy, dear friends, we have two types. That is, firstly, let us discuss about protogyny, and next we have protandry. So here, in the case of protogyny, we can see the maturation of gyne, it is referring to gyne. So maturation of the stigma will occur first, followed by the maturation of the anthers. So here, in case of protandry, you can see andry refers to andrecium. So the maturation of the anthers will occur first, followed by the maturation of the stigma. So here there is a time interval between the maturation of stigma and the anthers. So this will avoid self-pollination and help in carrying out the process of cross-pollination. So examples for protogyny which we can easily bring out here are wheat, Michaelia, and also in the case of paddy we can find dichogamy. Then we have, in the case of protandry, let me tell you the examples, the best examples are sunflower and onion. So this is the one. And next, we also have self-sterility. So here, what happens is, most of the, in cases, we can find this in case of bisexual plants, where, in fact, due to self-sterility, what happens, after the release of the pollen grains from the anthers, they, in fact, fail to germinate on the stigma of the same flower. Hence, what has to occur? Cross-pollination. So hence this important aspect we need to remember. And examples, if I want to quote here, there are so many, but the best examples are Abutilon and Passiflora. Next, my dear friends, we also have harcogamy. So, in the case of harcogamy, we find a hood or certain covering on the stigmatic surface. On the stigma, on the surface of stigma, there is some covering. We also refer that to as hood. So, this avoids, in fact, the self-pollination and contributes for cross-pollination. As in the case of example, if I want to quote here, the best example can be taken as iris. So, this is the another type of outbreeding device. Next, moving further, we also have few more important aspects in case of outbreeding devices. Let us say, in case of clerodendron, the stamens and the, in fact, the style will move away from each other. When they move away from each other, they avoid self-pollination and contribute for cross-pollination. So, that is in the case of, as I said, your clerodendron we can find. There is one more important concept called heterostyle. So, this is different lengths of style and the stamens. So, we may have long styles and in fact short stamens or in fact long stamens and short styles. So, which results in fact cross-pollination, avoiding self-pollination. So, this is also one of the type. Okay, examples can be seen with respect to here. Primula, Jasminum, and also in the case of Oxalis. So, definitely we can find heterostyle. So, this is all about the outbreeding devices. As I said you, my dear friends, it is necessary for avoiding the self-pollination, the inbreeding depression, and carrying out the cross-pollination for having more variability, recombination, you know, and contributing for evolution. So, thank you very much.